Gwyn Llywelyn o'r Betws. I was brought up in a small holding on Betws Mountain side. At that time, there were a number of small holdings, and since they could not support a family, the man invariably went to work in the mines. There were also larger farms which were self-supporting, and they had their own machinery. The busiest time of the year was hay making, and as children we liked to help, but mainly play on the hay. As already mentioned, hay making was a very busy time. The larger farms got their hay in first, then went around the small holdings to cut their hay. The hay was left lying on the field for 2 or 3 days and being turned over every day. And when it was ready, it was loaded on to a gambo and transported to a hay shed. A gambo was nothing more than a cart with low railings at the side just to protect the wheels, and a post at each corner drawn by a horse. Tractors were rarely seen on those days. The larger farms kept sheep, which had to be sheared every year. And for sheep shearing, the farmers got together, and this was a time for gossiping. I remember them on one occasion talking together about a lady who had her own farm and a widow and had a lodger. And they wondered, of course, whether they were sleeping together. And one observant farmer said, "I don't know, but I always see enough clothes for one bed on the line." There was another farmer who would like schoolboys coming around the farm on occasions. And one of these occasions, he asked me if I'd go up to buy him a packet of cigarettes from a shop which was lower down than the Scotch Pine. And he said, she asks if it's for me, you say no. And I certainly wondered why, and I didn't expect her to ask if it was for that particular gentleman. Anyway, I got there. First thing he said was, "Is it for this particular person?" I said no. And of course, I had the cigarettes, which was a packet of Woodburns. As I said, I wondered why, and I'm sure you wonder why as well. And I found out since that she had a toilet at the end of the garden, which she was afraid that it would fall down when she was in it, and asked this farmer if he would come to repair it. Now, of course, and this is funnier in Welsh than in English, because he asked her, "Well, what if it passed wind?" In Welsh, "Beth os tarech chi gnec?" After which, of course, she wouldn't sell him anything from then on. Oh, that's all I got.